Hey everybody, Gage here from Sharp. Thank you so much for tuning in. It's a pleasure to have you with me. Today I thought I'd try to dispel some myths about the difficulty with regards to maintaining Japanese knives. And while I would concede that some Japanese knives are quite difficult to maintain and require a level of diligence that not everyone is prepared for to keep from rusting or discoloring, I would argue that there are many very easy to maintain Japanese knives out there as well. So in this video, we're going to talk about the three different levels of difficulty for maintenance that each of the knives here at the shop will fall under, and hopefully this will give you a good idea of what you're prepared for when getting into Japanese knives. So before we talk about each of these three different levels of difficulty with maintenance, I just wanted to talk to you guys about a process called sanmai or forge welding, and this technique is used by all of the blacksmiths we carry here at the shop and involves the layering of three different materials together to create a knife that is both durable, has a long lasting edge, but is easier to maintain and less susceptible to damage. Now, depending on which materials are used to create the knife, will determine how difficult the knife is to maintain. So the first category we're going to talk about is a completely stainless steel knife, and these are obviously the easiest to maintain. They will never turn colors, rust or oxidize, or discolor in any way. The only issue you can run into these, and you would face this issue with any knife, is scratching or aesthetic damage happening that way. But you will never see a stainless steel knife change colors at all. As I said, there are still completely stainless knives that are made using the sanmai or forge welding technique, but all three layers of steel are stainless. So the two outer layers and the stainless layer at the core. Now, the two stainless layers on the outside will be softer, more rust resistant steels, and the stainless steel at the core will be a little bit harder while still being very resistant to rust. So if you're not one to want to worry about your knife rusting or anything, stainless steel is the way to go. Second category we're going to talk about is stainless cladded knives. So these are knives that are made from carbon steel but have stainless steel welded to the outside. Now, this is a really, really fantastic way to get into carbon steels because you start to understand the maintenance involved with caring for carbon steel, and start getting yourself in the habit of wiping your knife down immediately after using it. These knives are great because it's not gonna punish you as much as the third category that we're gonna talk about. If you do, by accident leave it wet or, cut a lemon with it and forget to wipe it down right away. The only part of the blade that you have to worry about is right at the very edge where you're gonna see this wavy line. That wavy line is where the stainless steel is coming to an end and the carbon steel is poking out beyond that. So these are great knives because you get the benefit of the carbon steel at the cutting edge where you want it, which is gonna give you better edge retention, a better general cutting feel, and better sharpenability, but also gives you the advantage of the stainless steel on the sides of the blade, which is going to protect the majority of the blade from rust or oxidation and just make it easier to maintain. So the third category we're going to talk about is iron-cladded knives. And if you've watched our video about types of steel, you know that steel is just iron with carbon added to it. So iron itself is still susceptible to rust and oxidation, meaning this whole knife is susceptible to rust and oxidation. Iron is slightly less susceptible to rust than carbon steel is, but I wouldn't argue that cladding a knife in iron is going to make it any easier to maintain. What it will do though is make it a little bit more flexible and less susceptible to cracking or chipping. Iron is a little bit softer than steel, so it's, like I said, gonna add an element of sort of pliability to the steel. This particular knife that I'm showing you here has a Kurouchi finish on it, or a blacksmith's finish. So as the iron and steel is forged, it turns this black color, which is just left on the blade in this style of finish. And this black part will protect the blade from rust and oxidation. Now, every Kurouchi finish is a little bit different, so you'll have to get familiar with the maker that you're interested in and learn a little bit about their Kurouchi finish and how resilient it is. But this particular knife I'm showing you is made by Yoshimitsu Hamono, and in my experience, they make a very resilient Kurouchi finish, which stays on the knife for its entire life and won't rust or oxidize. So those are the three different categories or levels of difficulty with regards to maintaining your Japanese knife. Stainless steel being the easiest, stainless clad being the sort of middle of the road, and iron clad being the most difficult to maintain. So I hope you got some knowledge out of this video. If you did, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe to my channel for more knife related content. If you have any more specific comments or questions, be sure to leave them down below and I will be sure to answer you. But until next time, I hope you enjoyed my video and have a pleasant day.